Have you had a hard time finding an aesthetic injector? Let's find one for you. So I'm asked on here all the time, I don't live near you. Can you recommend somewhere where I can go get a procedure done, an aesthetic clinic or provider? And unfortunately, I don't have a list around the country or around the world for people to go see, but I want to address why it's so difficult, first of all, and then give you some ways or what to look for to find a really good fit in your area. So the first thing to really understand is, why is it so hard to find a great aesthetic injector or even to walk in the door and talk to one and kind of break the ice? The first and the most common problem is style. The reason that you're picking an injector is, yes, knowledge, is, yes, the procedure, yes, your outcome, but the style of your provider. What do I mean by that? It really has to do with the mindset that you have, the ideas that you have, how you want to communicate with your practitioner, and how receptive they are to that. Some people come in and they say, Rajani, I want X amount of filler here, there, I want a thread here, and we have to slow them down. And over time, we, what I call negotiate, and you can go back and I'll put down below, I think a good video to watch is negotiating the consult to get an idea on this, but you're really negotiating with the provider what you want, what you think you want, and what you think they should do. So the style and how direct you are with them and they are with you and how receptive everyone is very complex, but it's probably the number one factor that separates someone going to a clinic and being happy and not. Number two is setting. If we take minimally invasive procedures or the med spa world, if you want to call it that, there are so many different settings and it means something different to everyone. Some people want a clinic with the utmost privacy, one door, one room. Other people like to go to a big boutique with multiple skincare lines where they're getting a skin analysis, they spend 2 hours, and they come out with product and their procedure. They want some pampering. Other people want to go to a medical clinic type of office. So it's really hard when someone says, hey, can you recommend a provider? There are so many different ways that these services are provided. There's no one standard. The third most difficult thing is the procedure itself. So someone might see a procedure here on this channel. Let's take a PDO thread or a thread lift, an infinity thread, the new threads. And we could recommend, go see this provider in your town. Maybe they're not doing the infinity thread. Maybe it doesn't suit their style. Maybe they don't like mixing Plasmasculpt, Sculptor, and PRF around the thread, or they want you to wait 6 months. Every provider, based on their experience and what they're seeing happening to your look, your skin surface, the lift, projections, and angles, are going to have what we talked about, the different style, but also a different breadth of procedures, different tools in their toolbox to achieve the result. So it's really hard to ask someone to name a provider that they're gonna go see or they should see, and to think that they might be happy with that provider with all those variables. So what do we do? How do you base your decision? Well, there's three main factors. The number one is get consults. So I always recommend to someone, go get 3 consults without the idea of necessarily getting treated. So if you get a consult, you get a good feel for the style, for the location, and to see if your ideas and your outcomes are congruent with your provider. I think that's the best way, and hopefully you get one of those consults, might be from a friend, and everyone talks about these procedures now. It's no big secret. So hopefully one of those will be a referral from a friend that goes somewhere that they're happy. Doesn't mean you're gonna be happy, because it's very common too that a friend might come and not identify because they have a different set of ideas of how they wanna look and how they wanna communicate with their provider, but it really does help. The second thing that you're gonna look for is passion and education. Those are things that you're going to know right away. If your provider has a passion, typically they're educating a lot. In this field, it's no longer a 4-hour, 8-hour course. We do day-long courses, we do weekend-long courses, but really to learn this world of aesthetics, and I'm not even including devices, just injectables, we'll say, it's like doing a 4 to 6 to 8 month internship to really learn how to do it. And to put that commitment in, what you're going to find is the person you see is going to have a lot of passion for what they do and will exude that passion. So you're looking for those two qualities. The third thing is start small. You don't have to start with a full face rejuvenation or full package and spend a lot of money in one place. Get a consult, get a smaller treatment, see if you like the outcome, see what the follow-up is, and see if the location and the provider are consistent. So if you start in that way, oftentimes it gives you an evaluation period. So those are three things to do. And I should add one thing not to do that's very common. People decide where they're gonna go based on a before and after picture. And before and afters, everyone wants to see them. They love to see results, see what can be done. Understand a before and after picture of this person has absolutely nothing to do with the before and after of the next person. People's skin reacts differently. What this model or person needs is very different. Lip filler is a classic when people come in with a before and after of a lip that they like. As we're filling lips, as an example, we're looking to see the projections, what can be done, how is the lip reacting to certain techniques. And so it doesn't mean that that before and after applies to you. Same with a full face or collagen stimulating treatments. Some people might need 2, you might need 4 to 6. So picking a place based on before and afters is very common, but it's a road to failure in most cases. Use the aforementioned ways. And that's my advice to people. So you might get this video when you ask me, hey, can you recommend a provider? I think those are the factors to think about. And now you know the reason why. If it was very easy to run aesthetic clinics, Silicon Valley would have done it a long time ago, and it would be like a Starbucks. And it's not there yet because of the three initial factors that are so very difficult. Pop over to Instagram. You'll see great conversations over there. And also join and subscribe to this YouTube channel to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.